Your own home isn't an investment, and that may sound strange, but let me explain. A while back, I read the book Rich Dad Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki, and in case you haven't read it, it's not that great, so you're not really missing out on much. However, there is one thing that really stuck with me from his book. To give some background, the writer divided everything up into assets, things that generate money, like stocks and bonds, for example, or liabilities, things that cost money, like for example a car or groceries or those types of things. But in the book he also said to put your own house in the liabilities category, which may sound completely counterintuitive. At first you may think that owning a house is a great investment because you pay it off every single month, and in the end you are left with a house that is your own. So it should be a great investment, especially when you compare it to renting. But herein lies the main problem. Your own house cannot be really categorized as an investment, because in most cases you are going to need a place to live anyway. And in the case that you want to live in your house for the rest of your life, so you don't intend on selling it later on, it can hardly be categorized as an investment. So in other words, you can't really profit from any additional value that your house generates by appreciating in value over the years. Also, for most people, it is unlikely that your house will generate money. There are a couple exceptions to this rule, like for example house hacking, or when you Airbnb or rent out a room or part of your house, but for most people that will not be the case, so I'm not going to touch upon it here. So basically the main argument is here that unless you intend to sell your house, your own house, later down the line, you aren't recouping any of the costs that you put in over the years. I also discussed this previously in another video, and this holds true in most cases that the average cost for a home just in maintenance costs alone is about 1-2% of the value of the property each and every year, on average of course. This means that if your house costs 200,000, then you need to set aside about 2-4,000 every single year just for maintenance costs on the property. And yes, you might not need any or not make have any costs 1 year, but then another year your boiler needs replacing, and that can already cost a lot of money. The same goes for when a roof needs replacing or when you need to refurbish your kitchen, for example. Those are all costs that you need to calculate in over the lifespan of a property. It also speaks for itself that the larger the property or the more expensive it is to buy, that will also mean that you need to take into account more costs on average every single year to maintain it. I mean, it makes sense. If you have more roof than an average property, for example, then it will also cost a lot more to replace. The same with the amount of windows you have or the size of your kitchen. A small kitchen can really be done quite or can be refurbished quite cheaply, but if you have a large kitchen in a large house, then it will cost obviously a lot more money. Also, a lot of improvements that you do in your own home that can cost a lot of money might not necessarily translate to a higher resale value. Your garden, for example, can cost a lot of money, and at least from my experience here in Belgium, there isn't that much justification for a difference in price when you have one house with this, or two houses with the same piece of land on both sides, where one has a bewildered mess of a garden and the other one has just some grass on it. There won't be that big of a price difference, if one at all, while it can still cost a lot of money to redo the entire garden in the case where it is a bewildered mess. So, long story short, your own house only costs you money. It will cost even more if it's a big house. And on top of that, you can only recoup the costs that you made if you intend to sell the house later down the line, which isn't always the case if it's your own house. And on top of all that, you also have the added factor that home improvements that you make might not necessarily translate to a higher resale value. So there is a chance you might not even recoup them at all. That said, however, and that's also stated in the book, it is the best liability that you can possibly purchase long term. Since, in essence, you are still using your own house as a long-term savings jar, so that money isn't completely lost. And in the case where you want to move to somewhere else, or you suddenly need a large amount of cash and there is no other way to finance it, then you can still sell the house and at least recoup some of those costs that you made. But the thing is, and that's really what I want to highlight today, that your own house also costs money. And that's something that a lot of people forget. And especially the larger the house, the larger the money sink is. So to count it as an actual investment is just the wrong idea. So why am I telling you this? Well, if you are on the fence about building or purchasing your expensive dream house, then by all means do so, but don't kid yourself into thinking it is a great investment or a great monetary investment, because it just isn't. It might still be a great idea for your own mental well-being, or if you really, really want that type of house, then by all means do so. But just don't kid yourself into thinking it is a great investment. If, however, your goal is to generate wealth, then you are better off by living well below your means. And living in a smaller and especially cheaper house. That way you can save even more by not spending everything on maintenance costs of the property alone. And you can save and invest more every single year. And the thing is that by doing this, you can still buy the house of your dreams later on in life. But do so when you have other assets that can at least pay for the maintenance costs of that property, so you can still maintain a really nice standard of living. I say this because otherwise you have way too much invested in your own property. There will be way too much costs involved with that. And that means that you will have not that much money left over for using in other purposes, be it investing or traveling or somewhere else. And even if you didn't listen to 90% that I just said, then just remember this one thing. If you want to buy a house, think also of the long-term costs of owning it and realize that it will cost money. And especially if the house is larger, then it will cost even more money. And you need to be willing also to spend that much every single year. And really keep that in mind when you want to purchase one. My next video will also be a follow-up on this video, where I will discuss how much house you can actually afford. So if that is something that you are interested in, then you know the drill, hit the subscribe button, like, and comment down below. And then I hope to see you next time. Bye.